Our mission at SD Bullion is clear: the lowest cost gold and silver available online. While we do not have pretty blue boxes, free shipping, 4% credit card fees, or glamorous gold and silver infomercials, SD Bullion has the lowest prices that may save you hundreds on your next order. So before you make your next investment, do the math and join the over 15,000 new customers who have recently made the switch to SD Bullion. Why pay more?
You've also discussed about how the petrodollar machinery continues to be dismantled. How will this affect the economic reset?
By petrodollar machinery, I really mean the complex derivatives. And this whole sequence of petrodollar dismantling has been like a preparatory event leading up to the climax. It started about 2 years ago. And it's a long, drawn-out process, but I think it was motivated in large part by the U.S. and British stealing the Arabs' gold held in Swiss banks. And the climax event had to do with UBS and Credit Suisse and, you know, just kind of thin cover for excuses. They said that they violated the Iran sanctions and they were making a lot of U.S. private accounts for tax dodging and all this. No, that was a false pretense. They just wanted to take control of the Swiss banks to steal the rest of the Arab gold. So the Arabs and the Saudis decided, you know, we're going to do our own thing. They're going to, you know, have these conferences every month with the Chinese and a lot of different things. But here's what the petrodollar machinery is all about. They're huge contracts. They're like trillion-dollar contracts that link crude oil and the dollar and the euro and the British pound, and all kinds of combinations in there to form a network that acts like a platform. It's the contractual equivalent of the gold standard applied to the crude oil asset. So it made the de facto oil backing for the dollar. And you can get into all kinds of weird discussions and arguments and say, no, the dollar had no backing. It's a fiat currency. Well, that's true, but it also had a de facto practical backing in the form of crude oil, where the Saudis agreed and all the Arab Emirates followed suit. The Arabs agreed that they would take all of their crude oil sales and all the payments and what they call the petro surpluses, and they would hold them in treasury bond form and not sell them. So that completed the recycle, but it did not involve any sale of the dollar after the crude oil transaction. In other words, keep it all in the dollar family. Okay. All these contracts have been gradually dismantled. They couldn't do them all at once because it's so big. I mean, if you've got 700 quadrillion, I'm sorry, 700 trillion or $1 quadrillion dollars worth of derivatives, a large part is interest rate derivatives, but another large part is the petrodollar crude oil derivatives linking with the currencies. Okay, this machinery is being dismantled, and an interesting phenomenon happened that took a lot of people by surprise and took me a while to figure it all out or to figure out most of it. It's impossible to figure all this out. But when a big petrodollar contract is dissolved, it must be settled in dollars. So it created a tremendous demand for dollars. And that is one of the biggest reasons why the dollar went up. The dollar went up from dissolution and removal and final liquidation of petrodollar contracts denominated in U.S. dollar terms. And I like to make a point. This is a recent explanation of mine. I've been saying the dollar's dying, and I get a lot of really stupid, abusive email from people. I think it's largely, you know, two or three people using silly names and false emails so I can't write back to them and tell them how stupid they are. But they say, oh, you got it wrong, Jim. The dollar's still going up. And that's exactly what I said. The symptom of the dollar death is its rise and rise and continued rise. But here's how I like to explain it now. If we got off the gold standard to back the dollar in 71, and then in 73 we quickly got on the petrodollar de facto standard, what better evidence that the dollar is dying than the crude oil price is descending? But as the crude oil price goes down, since the petrodollar machinery is not all gone, the cantilever, the opposite teeter-totter effect, is at work. Crude oil goes down, the dollar goes up. But as the dollar goes up, that forces the gold price down. So this is all going to break. It's just think of a bunch of like hundreds of balloons tied together, floating up. Eventually, the air pressure is absent, and the pressure inside, the air inside the balloons is too great, and all the balloons pop. This is what's going to happen to the dollar. Okay, we're not. There are a lot of people who misquote me. They say, "Well, Jim, expecting the dollar to crash." No, I'm expecting it to disappear. If you have balloons floating up and suddenly they pop, the balloons don't crash to the earth. They explode at a high altitude, and that's exactly what's going to happen.
Click here to subscribe for free, so you will be notified when more of this interview is released. Or click over here to watch the full interview now. This video was brought to you by ReluctantPreppers.com. Click here to watch Reluctant Preppers interview with Andy Hoffman, where Andy Hoffman explains how to store gold and silver.